I am Dr.Venkataram Mysore, dermatologist, dermatopathologist, hair transplant surgeon and director at Venkat Center for Skin, ENT and Plastic Surgery, Vijayanagar, Banashankari, Cunningham Road, Bangalore. Is stem cell therapy useful for hair loss management? Regenerative therapy, what does it mean? Now, in hair loss management, drugs have hit a plateau. We have not had great drugs since minoxidil and finasteride, to some extent dutasteride. Surgery has seen significant advances. FUT, FUE, body hair, all these are useful. But many people may not want surgery. Devices, lasers, there is some excitement, but still they are not perfect. Genetic treatments, cloning, they are not here. We have been discussing them, but they are not here. Not now, at least. What is new is what is called regenerative therapy, wherein you use certain body products, stem cells, growth factors, cytokines, and then use them for treatment. These are called biological regenerative treatments for hair loss. What are these? One which is very commonly used from blood is called platelet-rich plasma. It is done routinely. It has some significant evidence. It is usually done 4 sessions and is quite useful. The next one is stem cell treatment. Stem cells are primordial cells which can change into any type of cell depending on the location. You can see this diagram here. There are multiple places where stem cells are located. The stem cells are in the fat. We have a separate video for that. Stem cells are in the root and they are also present in what is called the bulge area, where the hair follicle is attached with the muscle. There are ways to extract the stem cells through a machine mechanically, and then you get a suspension which is then injected into the hair loss area. So such machines have been introduced and doctors have been using it also. One word of caution, I mentioned that PRP is here to stay, is quite useful, but the same cannot be said for these other treatments. There is not much of evidence for these treatments, it's still level of evidence C. So it is usually not a first line routine standard treatment, it is a second or third line treatment in resistant cases. And while we do it in our center, we are seeing early results, but whether they are useful for advanced grade of baldness, that is still not clear. So more data is needed before we can recommend this treatment in regular routine use. However, this is an exciting area. Many new advances are happening and many new sources of stem cells are also being explored. So we can expect more significant developments in this field, and at that time we'll come back to you with latest information. Thank you.